It was Ian Kinsley, and it was Chris Davis, who were still with the Rangers in the Red Street, and they're out in right field in the seats, wondering what they're doing. And they were out there arguing about where the ball that Josh Hamilton had hit in batting practice the previous day had landed. Now, I'm not sure they ever figured out where the ball landed, but I know this. They were 100 feet past the Red Sea. You know about the Red Sea. That's the sea in Fenway Park's right field where Ted Williams in 1946 hit a 502-foot home run. Josh was 100 feet further with a batting practice home run.
What if the ball comes out here? How are we going to catch it?
And his teammates were marveling at the accomplishment. Josh had a backup.
Hey,
other major league players, guys who are among the best at what they do in the world, were amazed by what he did. All of the players that loved Josh, they protected Josh, they respected Josh. But David Murphy and Josh had a special relationship. They were close friends for all the time they played together as teammates with the Rangers. Please welcome former Ranger player and current broadcaster, David Murphy.
Things on the field each and every for a while. Murph showed up, Nelly showed up. What's up, man? Yeah. And all of a sudden, Josh shows up. And that changed everything. Right after that, here comes Cliff, here comes Cole, here comes Nat, here comes Adrian. And Josh is the one who started everything. It was, I don't know if I want to say legitimacy, but I think every team knew that when they came to play us, you know, 1-9, we were going to be a dangerous team. And that started with this guy.
All right, now I put you on the spot, as I did with regard to his talent. All the guys
certainly, we have played with Hodge, we played with Vaughn, which is unbelievably talented guys. The things that Josh was doing on the baseball field, physically, I've never seen anything like in my life. He was hurt all the time, whether it was crashing into a wall or getting a fight with a moose, I don't know what he did, something. He was always banged up, playing through everything, and was still the best player in the field every night. I've never seen more talented baseball player than Josh Young.
Mike Young, ladies and gentlemen. Nice memories, Mike. Thank you so much. Another letter. I got a copy of this one for you. Dear Josh, congratulations on your induction into the Texas Rangers Baseball Hall of Fame. Warren and I are pleased to join you and your family and friends in congratulating you on this special occasion. I always loved watching you play. This milestone reflects your incredible talent, and I appreciate your contributions to the Rangers. We send our best wishes. May God bless you. Sincerely, George W. Got the president in seal. On December 22nd, 2007, the Rangers made one of the oldest trades in the history of the franchise. They traded Edinson Bolkins, Fat Man, Danny Herrera, Josh Allen. History tells us that the trade worked out great, but trade for a 26-year-old who had just 1 year in the big leagues and history of off-the-field problems was nothing but
gold.
The man who pulled the trigger on that trade is with us tonight. President and General Manager John Daniels here now to unveil Josh's Hall of Fame. Watch the screens for one last look back at this meteor.